So I'm here at Flash Boxing, George Diaz. Introduce us, who's here today?
We're with Carlos Pena.
What's up, Carlos? What's up? He's not Mexican.
No, he's half Salvadorian, half Puerto Rican.
Puerto Ricans, very good fighters.
Yeah, yeah.
We got Miguel Cotto.
Yep.
So today we're teaching how to throw an actual, just a basic jab. Nothing really too special, just throwing a basic jab. Commit to it.
George, what's the most common mistake do you see people do when they throw jabs?
They throw lazy jabs.
What do you mean?
They always do this. When they throw the jab, put their left hand down. That's always a common mistake I used to do.
And then you get slapped.
You know, you get smacked or you get really hit with a right hand, you know, a rocking right hand. But that's the basic shot that you always, you could create opportunities. You create something out of it, you know. You can be use it as being defensive, you know, if you're moving around, like move around corners, use it. You know, you stick it and moving. Or you can be an aggressive, start just stepping in with the jab.
Okay, that's one thing to work on it in a ring, but not everybody have a ring at home. But many people sometimes will have a bag.
It's basic, like let's just say if they had a bag or they have just basic, you just push off the right foot. Jab. Very technical. Jab. Use the shoulder to defend your chin, and you turn your punch.
How many rounds should you practice when you practice it? 3, 6, 9?
You know, with the belt, with just basic, you know, just it could be as much as you want. You could, well, you know, averagely 4 or 5 rounds, you know, when you do a shadow box. But just with the jab, you know, 2 rounds, 1 round, but just your jab, close your hand. But now with the closing your hand is very different from different trainers. I like to teach my fighters to keep their hands closed at all times, just to get a habit of keeping their hands closed. Some trainers like to keep their hands open, so they just flinch the jab. And I don't got nothing against it. You know, it's a good way. You know, you're able to move and stick and move. Let's create the movements right here.
But with the hand closed, what does it do?
It just creates more force into it.
But how do you defend with the closed hands at all times?
Is just the thing is, you relax your shoulder, but you keep the wrist and the forearm tense. The shoulders relax. So you got something behind. You basically got a 4x4 hitting you, really. So that's just the basics, you know. But like I said, different trainers have different philosophies of it. Some trainers like it with their open hands. Some trainers like to keep their hands closed. So it depends.
For someone who's never ever shadow boxed, what's the basics? Is there a right or wrong? Is it freestyle or?
You always want to stay with the just. Technically, you know how a textbook teaches you? They teach you the right hand, the jab, the right hand, left hook. Practice basics. Boom, 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 boom. Nice and technical until you get it correct. Everything comes from your hips to your shoulders and your feet. Go. 1, 2, hook, right hand. And just stay right there. Go back on your forearm. That's basically it. And pick up from there.
There you have it. Stay tuned. George Diaz right here at Flashboxing, FiusionsReport.com. And Mike Sickback reporting. We'll be right back.